Praise the Lord, everybody.
Praise the Lord.
Let's stand.
都是我们的
It's good to see you in the house of the Lord tonight.
我要得,很好意思,我要知道。
I don't know about you, but I'm excited about things going back to normal.
我要得,很好意思,我要知道。
I think we're going to clap our hands. Some of you just can't stop smiling. Some of you can't stop smiling. As it becomes normal in our world again, hopefully soon, don't let normal be in here. Let the power of the Lord touch us tonight. Don't let this be a normal service tonight. Let God touch you in a special way. And the way that's going to happen is if we will touch Him in a special way.
If
we will open up and worship Him and praise Him. He cannot resist that. Praise God. I want the Lord to come into this place in a powerful way. Why don't we raise our hands? Why don't we raise our voices? Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord, for the privilege to be with your people. To lift up the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Glory to God. Glory to Jesus. Oh, hallelujah! Hallelujah! Praise God! Praise God! We love you, Lord! We praise you, Almighty God! Hallelujah! Hallelujah! Glory to God! Glory to God! Glory to God! Glory to God. Hallelujah! Hallelujah! Praise God! Praise God! Might have some folks joining us in Moscow. Some in St. Pete. And hopefully a whole bunch here in Estonia. Let's love the Lord tonight with all of our hearts. Let's lift Him up in song. Let's give Him praise.
Oh, yeah. You are God alone, from the Lord on the earth. Se amo que tu Moses, in the Hall of David. Down in Syria, so soon on the day there, so soon as we keep those all on. Just reach out to your Heavenly Father. He's able to touch and He's able to heal. How about if anybody has ever been healed by the Lord Jesus Christ, why don't you say amen? As God made a way when there was no way,
hallelujah,
He can do it again. Praise God. Amen. I feel the presence of the Lord tonight. And I'm looking forward so much to the Word of the Lord. And today we're so thankful to have all the way from Riga, Latvia. Mark and Robin Schutz. For those of you that know, they founded this church in Tallinn. Estonia, all the way to the border with China.
15
nations.
We're
not traveling a lot right now. And we're so blessed to have them as the first place that they've come after this quarantine.
Praise the Lord, everybody. We're so thankful to be with all of you tonight, those that are here and watching.
And
there's been a common theme in this music tonight. And also in my spirit. Because God is faithful. No matter if we're on a mountain,
olenemata sellest, kas me oleme mäe peal või me kõnnime läbi surmavari oru.
Our God is faithful.
Meil Jumal on usta.
And He proves Himself faithful time and time and time.
Ja ta tõestab oma ustavust.
I want to read in Isaiah 44.
Ma tahan lugeda Jesaja 44. peatükis.
Starting in verse 6.
Salmist 6 alates.
Israel's King and Redeemer, the Lord of Heaven's armies.
Nõnda ütleb Issand, Iisraeli kuningas ja tema lunastaja, vägede Issand.
I am the first and the last.
Ma olen esimene ja viimane.
There is no other God.
Ja ei ole muud jumalat.
Who is like me?
Kui mina.
Let him step forward to prove to you his power.
Kes on minu sarnane, see lüütku, jutkus saabu sellest ja kantku mulle ette.
Let him do as I have done since ancient times.
Sest ajast, kui ma seadsin muistse rahva.
When I established a people and explained its future.
Ja tulevased sündmused.
Do not tremble.
Jutustage mulle selles, mis on tulemas.
Do not be afraid.
Ärge väisega ja ärge karta.
Did I not proclaim my purposes for you long ago?
Kas ma ei ole sulle juba ammu kuulutanud ja teatavaks teinud?
You are my witnesses.
Teie olete mu tunnistajad.
Is there any other God?
Kas on muud jumalat kui mina?
No, there is no other rock, not
ei,
one.
Muud kaljud ei ole, mina küll ei.
Amen. He is your all in all.
Tema on sinu kõik ja kõik.
Everything and anything you need.
kõik, mida sa vajad.
And he will prove it time and time and time again.
Ja ta tõestub seda pidevalt.
He is the first,
tema on esimene,
and he is the last.
Tema on viimane.
He is your first,
tema on sinu esimene,
and he is your last.
Ja ta on sinu viimane.
He is the author and the finisher of your faith.
Ta on sinu usu
Amen. He is our everything.
Ta on meie kõigeks.
So whatever you need tonight,
ja mida iganes sa vajad täna,
whether you're celebrating high on a mountaintop,
kas sa oled tähistamas kõrgel mäedikus?
Are walking in the valley of the shadow of darkness.
Või kõndimas läbi surmavarju ja oru.
Our God is there.
Ja Jumal on
seal. And he will prove to you that he is there.
Ja ta tõestab, et ta on seal.
If you will only have an open heart.
Kui sa vaid omad avatud südant.
And eyes that will see.
Ja silmi, mis näevad.
Ears that will hear.
Ja kõrvu, mis kuulevad.
He will prove himself to you.
Ta tõestab ennast sinule.
Lord bless you all.
Issand, ma issand, et kõik.
Praise the Lord, everyone. So thankful to be here with all of you. Thank you, Pastor Turner, for the opportunity to be here. So thankful for you and your family. So thankful for the Moses and their family. So thankful for our amazing interpreter. I'm so thankful for each one of you. You all are very precious to the Lord.
And
it is such an honor to be back in
Tallinn.
And my wife and I love Tallinn.
Mina ja mu naine, me armastame Tallinnat.
We lived here for about 6 years.
Me elasime siin kokku umbes 6 aastat.
And we wanted to live here the rest of our lives.
Ja tahaks, oleksime tahtnud elada üle elu siin.
But we live in Riga and we have the opportunity to come back and forth sometimes.
Aga me elame Riias ja aeg-ajalt on võimalus tulla nende kahe vahel.
So it's an honor to be back in Tallinn, Estonia.
Nõnda on au olla tagasi Tallinnas, Eestis.
And today for a little bit.
Täna pisut aega.
I always say a little bit just in case.
Ma alati ütlen pisut igaks juhuks.
So that you will have strength to endure.
Et teil oleks jõud, vaid püsida vastu.
So that you will believe with me that I will not speak too long.
Et ma ei kõnele liiga kaua.
But I want to relate to you what the Lord encouraged me to talk to you about tonight. This is a message I have only spoken in a couple of different countries.
See on sõnum, mida ma olen ainult paaris teises riigis.
I've been very careful to speak it.
Ma olen väga ettevaatlikult sellest rääkinud.
And the Lord began to deal with me about it only a year ago.
Ja issand hakkas minuga see teema tegelema umbes aasta tagasi.
It has greatly impacted my life.
Ja see on väga suuresti minu elu mõjutanud.
So I want to begin in the word of the Lord in Revelation.
Nõnda ma tahan alustada issanda sõnast.
Chapter 20.
Imutuse raamatu 20.
Verses 11 through 14.
Salmid 11 kuni 14.
11 through 14. I mean 15.
And
I saw a great white throne, and him that sat on it, from whose face the earth and the heaven fled away, and there was found no place for them.
Ma nägin suurt valget trooni ning seda, kes sellel istub, kelle valgest põgenesid maa ja taevas ning neile ei leidunud aset.
And I saw the dead, small and great, stand before God, and the books were open, and another book was open, which is the book of life, and the dead were judged out of those things which were written in the books, according to their works.
Ja ma nägin surnuid suuri ja pisikesi seisab trooni ees ning raamat avati, teine raamat avati, see on nebu raamat. Ja surnute üle mõisteti kogud seda mööda, kuidas raamatuisse oli kirjutatud nende kohe järgi.
And the sea gave up the dead which were in it, and death and hell delivered up the dead which were in them, and they were judged every man according to their works.
Ja meri andis tagas oma surnud ning surn ja surmavald andis tagas oma surnud ning iga ühe üle mõisteti kohut tema tegude järgi.
And death and hell were cast into the lake of fire. This is the second death.
Ja surm ja surmavald visati tulejärve. See on teine surm, tulejärv.
And whosoever was not found written in the book of life was cast into the lake of fire.
Keda iganes ei leitud olevat eduraamatusse kirjutatud, see visati tulejärve.
I used to think of the throne of God as this spectacular one throne, and streams of people would come to that one throne.
Varem ma mõtlesin Jumala troonis kui sellest vägeva suure väljumisega troonist, mille suunas inimpood liiguvad.
It was my perception of the throne of God.
See oli minu nägemus Jumala troonist.
As I began to study a little bit more,
ma hakkasin selle kohta rohkem uurima.
It's something much greater than that.
Siis on see midagi väga palju enamat kui see.
There is one throne.
On üks troon.
But there are judges that are there.
Aga seal on kohtumõistjad.
There are witnesses that are there.
Seal on tunnistajad, kes on seal olemas.
If you begin to look at it a little bit more in depth,
kui hakata detailsemaks seda vaatama.
This is actually a court.
See on tegelikkuses nagu kohtu ruum.
It looks something like a great court or a supreme court.
See näeb välja midagi sarnast nagu on ülemkohus kohtruum.
You have books that are open.
Raamatud, mis avatakse.
Everything you've done, everything you said is written down.
Kõik, mida sa oled teinud, kõik, mida oled öelnud, on kirja pandud.
Whether good or bad.
On see hea või halb.
Oh my Lord. Let's continue.
Yeah.
And so I'm going to talk just for a little bit about the heavenly courts.
Ja ma räägin pisut sellest taevasest kohtust.
I want to look at the book of Job.
Ma tahan vaadata Iobi raamatust.
I want to show you how this works a little bit.
Ja vaadata, kuidas see toimib.
By the time we get done, by God's grace, we will be strengthened and encouraged.
Ja selleks hetkeks, kui me jõuame lõpule, Jumala armu läbi, me oleme julgustatud ja tugevdatud.
Here's a little bit of how this works.
Ja siin on pisut, kuidas see toimib.
Job chapter 1, we're going to read verses 6 through 12. Job chapter 1, verses 6 through 12.
Iobi raamatu esimesest peatükis.
Whenever we're thinking about a court, we need a judge.
Kui me mõtleme kohturuumi osas, siis me peab olema kohtunik.
There will be an accuser.
Keegi, kes süüdistab.
There will be the accused.
See, kes on süüdistatav.
There will be witnesses. There has to be facts.
On tunnistaja, et peab olema olema fakte.
And hopefully you will have a lawyer.
Ja loodetavasti on sul ka kaitsja olemas.
That would be my recommendation.
See oleks minu soovitus.
Some people don't have a lawyer.
Mõningate inimestel seda ei ole.
We'll discuss that in just a few moments.
Seda osas me arutame ka.
Job chapter 1, verses 6 through 12.
Iobi esimese peatüki 6. salmis.
Now there was a day when the sons of God came to present themselves before the Lord, and Satan came also among them.
Ent ühel päeval, kui Jumal lapsed tulid ja seisid Issanda ees, tuli ka Saatan nende sekka.
And the Lord said unto Satan, whence comest thou? Then Satan answered the Lord and said, from going to and fro in the earth and from walking up and down in it.
Ja Issand küsis Saatanal, kus sa tuled? Ja Saatan vastas Issandale ning ütles, maa mööda hulkumast ja rändamast.
And the Lord said unto Satan, hast thou considered my servant Job, that there is none like him in the earth, a perfect and an upright man, one that feareth God and escheweth evil.
Siis Issand ütles Saatanale, kas oled pannud hääle sulast Iobit? Sest tema sarnast maa peal ei ole, magab ja õiglane mees, kardab Jumalat ja hoidub kurjast.
Then Satan answered the Lord and said, doth Job fear God for naught?
Saatan vastas Issandale ning ütles, kas Iob asjata Jumalat kardab?
Hast thou not made an hedge about him, about his house, about all that he hath on every side? Thou hast blessed the work of his hands, and his substance is increased in the land.
Eks sa oled teinud igas küljest aia ümber temale ja pojale ning kõigele, mis tal on. Sa oled õnnistanud tema kätetööd ja ta kari on siginenud maal.
But put forth thine hand now and touch all that he hath, and he will curse thee to thy face.
Aga pista ometi käsi tema külge ja puruta kõike, mis tal on, kas ta siis õnnistab su palet.
And the Lord said unto Satan, behold, all that he hath is in thy power, only upon himself put not forth thine hand. So Satan went from the presence of the Lord.
Siis Issand ütles Saatanale, vaata kõik, mis tal on, olgu sinu käes. Ära ainult pista kätt tema enese külge. Ja Saatan läks Issanda juurest ära.
We understand from Revelation chapter 12 and verse 10 that Satan is the accuser of the brethren.
Me mõistame ilmutuse raamatust, et Saatan on vendade süüdistaja.
Satan accuses God's people day and night.
Saatan süüdistab Jumala rahvast päeval ja ööl.
Sometimes we have this perception of Satan being in hell somewhere.
Vahel meil on nägemus Saatanast, et ta on kusagil põrgus.
But he's actually in heaven.
Aga ta on tegelikuses taevas.
Accusing us every day.
Süüdistamas meid iga päev.
Bringing court cases against us.
Tuues neid kohtu avaldusi meie vastu.
In Revelation chapter 12, he will be cast out of heaven, but until then he is there.
ja inimese rahvas on kirjas, et ta ühel hetkel visatakse taevast välja, aga kuni sel hetkeni on ta seal.
And so we can see in this passage
nõnda me näeme selles kirjas,
that Satan is looking for an advantage.
Et Saatan otsib seda
how can võimalus, he get Job to curse God?
Võimalus, et kuidas panna Iob Jumalat neema.
He wanted to find a weak spot in Job.
Ta tahtis leida Iobi juures nõrga koha.
And God allowed all of it to happen.
Ja Jumal lubas sellel kõigel aset leida.
So that he could bless Job.
Nõnda, et ta saaks Iobi õnnistada.
God is looking out for you.
Jumal on sinu peale vaatamas.
Even in your difficulties.
Ka sinu raskustes.
Even in your weaknesses.
Ka sinu nõrkustes.
God has your best interest in mind.
Jumal on sinu parimad väljavaated silmas.
Jesus is not the accuser of the brethren.
Jeesus ei ole vendade süüdistaja.
He is the savior of the world.
Ta on maailma päästja.
He is full of mercy and grace.
Ta on täis armu ja halastust.
If you were the only one to save, he would have died on the cross to save you.
Kui sina oleksid olnud ainukene, keda saaks päästa, siis ta surnuks sinu eest ristil.
And even today, if he had to do it again, he would do it again for you.
Isegi täna, kui ta peaks seda uuesti tegema, ta teeks seda uuesti sinu jaoks.
Because of his great love for us.
Tema suure armustuse tõttu meie vastu.
So we need a lawyer.
Nõnda, meil on vaja kaitsjat.
Let's look in 1 John.
Vaatame esimese Johannesi kirjas.
We're going to look at chapter 2.
Peatükis 2.
Verses 1 and 2 are just verse 1.
Saimist 1.
My little children, these things write I unto you, that you sin not, and if any man sin, we have an advocate with the Father, Jesus Christ, the righteous.
Lapsed, seda ma kirjutan teile, et te ei teeks pattu, aga kui keegi pattustab, siis on meil eeskostja isa juures, Jeesus Kristus, kes on õige.
Thank the Lord.
Tänu Jumalale.
We have a lawyer.
Meil on kaitsja, eeskostja.
When you have received God, the Holy Spirit in your life.
Kui sa oled vastu võtnud Jumala oma ellu, püha vaimu.
You have received the lawyer.
Oled sa vastu võtnud selle
eeskostja. Who fights for you.
Kes sinu eest võitleb.
Who stands in court for you?
Kes seisab kohtus sinu eest.
And defends you.
Ja kaitseb sind.
Because of his great name.
Tema vägeva nime tõttu.
And because of his blood.
Ja tema vere tõttu.
Because of his grace and mercy.
Tema armu ja halastuse tõttu.
Amen.
Now I want to look at John chapter 15.
Ja ma tahan vaadata Johannes evangeeliumi 15. peatükis.
Remember this word that we found in 1 John chapter 2 and verse 1 about the advocate.
Hoiame meeles seda sõna, mida me nägime esimese Johannese kirjas, eeskostja.
So we are going to look at John chapter 15 verses 26 and 27.
Ja vaatame Johannese evangeeliumi 15. peatüki 26 ja 27 salmid.
But when the comforter is come, whom I will send unto you from the Father, even the Spirit of truth, which proceedeth from the Father, he shall testify of me.
Kui tuleb lohutaja, kelle ma teile isa juures saadan, tõevaim, kes lähtub isast, siis tema tunnistab minust.
And ye shall bear witness because you have been with me from the beginning.
Ja teiegi tunnistate, sest te olete olnud minuga algusest peale.
Now this is a very interesting passage.
Ja see on huvitav kirjakoht.
I'm not sure what it says in Estonian, but when the comforter has come, what is that in Estonian? The comforter. Same? And Greek, it is the same word that we find in 1 John chapter 2 and verse 1, the advocate.
On sõna sama, mida me nägime Johannes esimeses Johannese kirjas eeskostja.
So when we're talking about the comforter here, we're talking about the lawyer.
Ja kui me nüüd räägime siin, kui me loeme siin lohutajast, siis me räägime sellest eeskostjast.
Now let's look at this a little bit differently.
Vaatame seda pisut teise nurga alt.
But when the lawyer is come,
kui eeskostja tuleb,
whom I will send you from the Father, even the Spirit of truth,
tõevaim,
which proceedeth from the Father, and he shall testify of me.
Kes lähtub isast, siis tema tunnistab minust.
This is a court term.
See on kohtu termin.
These are words that are used in court.
Need on sõnad, mida kasutatakse kohtupidamisel.
To testify.
Tunnistada.
The next verse says to bear witness.
Ja anda tunnistust ja järgmine sõna, järgmine salm ütleb, et tunnistada.
And so you can see here that we need this great lawyer in our lives. John
14.
Johannes 14. In verse
26.
But the Comforter, which is the Holy Ghost, whom the Father will send in my name, he shall teach you all things and bring all things to your remembrance whatsoever I have said unto you.
Aga lohutaja, püha vaim, kelle isa saadab minu nimel, tema õpetab teile kõik ja tuletab teile meelde kõik, mida ma teile olen öelnud.
Again, this is speaking about the lawyer, the advocate.
Veel kord, siin on räägitud sellest eespoistest, sellest kaitsjast.
So in a courtroom, we have a judge.
Kohtusaalis meil on kohtunik.
It happens to be that he is our judge and lawyer.
Juhtumisi on ta nii meie kohtunik kui ka meie kaitsja.
Don't be afraid.
Ärge katke seda.
Your judge happens to be your lawyer.
Sinu kohtunik on juhtub olema samuti ka sinu kaitsja.
He is looking out for you.
Ta kannab hoolt sinu eest.
Now your accuser has actual facts.
Nüüd sinu süüdistajal on faktid olemas.
He's not bringing lies to the throne.
Ta ei too trooni ette valesid.
Because God would know it.
Kuna Jumal teaks seda.
He's bringing actual facts of things you have said and things you have done.
Ta toob esile reaalsed faktid, mida sa oled öelnud ja mida sa oled teinud.
The amazing thing is,
hämmastav selle juures on,
if you sin, if you fail,
kui sul asjad ebaõnnestuvad, kui sa teed pattu,
Satan writes it down.
Saatan paneb selle kirja.
These demons write it down, they get up there to heaven, to the court.
Ja nad viivad selle taevasse kohtu ette.
And if you have repented of your sin,
kui sa oled parandanud oma pattudes,
the Bible says that God is faithful and just to forgive you of your sin.
Piibis on kirjas, et Jumal on ustav ja õigane, et need andeks anda sulle.
And when he arrives at court,
kui ta saabub kohturuumi,
and he brings the accusation against you,
ja toob esile need süüdistused sinu vastu,
God can't find it.
Jumal ei leia neid üles enam.
And he judges you innocent.
Ja ta mõistab sind süütuks.
You are acquitted.
Sa oled õigeks mõistetud.
Innocent because of the blood of Jesus Christ.
Süüta, kuna Jeesuse vere tõttu.
Satan has a plan to destroy you.
Saatanal on plaan, et sind hävitada.
But God set everything up.
Aga Jumala seadnud kõige.
He makes it next to impossible for you to fail. Or fail not to be saved. He makes it almost impossible for you not to be saved.
Ta muudab selle peaaegu võimatuks, et sa ei saaks päästetud.
As long as you'll repent.
Seni kaua, kui sa oled meelt parandanud.
As long as you'll turn to him.
Seni kaua, kui sa pöördud tema poole.
He will do everything in his power.
Teeb ta kõik, mis on tema võimuses.
To save you.
Et sind päästa.
Hallelujah. There has been times in my life, actually this last year,
minu elus on olnud aeg, on siit seal juures eelmisel aastal.
I was upset at a situation.
Ma olin halb tuju ühe olukorra tõttu.
Don't worry, I already confessed my sins unto God.
Ärge muretsege, ma olen juba vabatud.
I just want to confess them to you.
Tõisa Jumalale, ma tahan neid, aga ka teile tunnistada.
And so I said something in the presence of God.
Ma ütlesin midagi Jumala ligiolus viibides.
I was upset in a situation.
Ma olin rahul olematu olukorraga.
And I spoke it incorrectly.
Ja ma kõnelesin ebakorrektselt.
I was upset.
Mul oli halb.
You probably never did this before.
Võib-olla sina ei ole mitte kunagi varem niimoodi teinud.
I did, I'm sorry.
Aga mina tegin, ma vabandan.
And I said it.
Ma ütlesin seda.
And God spoke to me.
Jumal kõneles minuga.
You have to take it back.
Sa pead selle tagasi võtma.
I said, okay.
Ma ütlesin, hea küll.
I said, Lord, I'm sorry, it was wrong.
Isad, andesta mulle, see oli valesti.
Oh, please forgive me.
Andesta mulle.
And I understood something.
Ja ma mõistsin midagi.
Here's why you have to take it back.
Siin on, mille tõttu tuli
isad. It may appear to be okay.
See võib olla väliselt oli okay.
But you did it from the wrong motive.
Aga sa tegid seda vale motiiviga.
You were angry at a situation.
Sa olid pahane olukorra peale.
And you spoke in a way that was not wise.
Ja kõnelesid viisi, mis ei olnud tark.
The enemy takes it.
Saatan võtab selle.
And goes to court.
Ja läheb kohtusse selle.
And he's going to use those very words against you.
Ja ta kasutab neid samu sõnu sinu vastu.
And the Bible says,
ja Biibel ütleb,
in Matthew 12 and 26, that every idle word will be judged.
Et Matteuse evangeeliumis on kirjas, et iga tühise sõna eest mõistetakse kohut.
There are accusations brought against us.
On süüdistused, mis tuuakse meie ette.
And it's very important that we take care of those things.
Ja on oluline, et me kannaksime hoolt nende asjade eest.
Satan wants to get a bad ruling on you.
Saatan tahab, et sa saaksid halva otsuse osaliseks.
He wants to hurt you.
Ta tahab sulle kahju teha.
He wants to get a bad judgment on you.
Ta tahab, et sa saaksid halva otsuse.
So that he has permission to act against you.
Et tal oleks luba sinu vastu tegutseda.
It's very important to take care of things of our past that we have not taken care of.
On oluline, et me kannaksime hoolt minevikus asetatud asjade eest.
If you've done something wrong against somebody,
kui sa oled kellegi vastu midagi valesti teinud,
don't go before the throne of God and act like everything is okay. First take care of what you did wrong.
Ära mine Jumala trooni ette tehes nägu, et midagi ei ole juhtunud.
Make sure your heart is right.
Esmalt tee asi korda. Veendu, et
take care of those mistakes.
Veendu, et sinu südam puhas ja kannab hoolt nende vigade eest.
You remember the story of Balak and Balaam? Balaam was a prophet in the Old Testament. Balak was a king.
Vanas testamentis oli prohvet ja kuningas.
Balak the king saw the Israelites, they had come out of Egypt, were going to the promised land.
Kuningas nägi, kuidas Israel tuli välja Egiptusest ja sammus tõotatud maa poole.
Balak was afraid that the Israelites would destroy him and his nation.
Ja ta kartis, et Israel tuleb tema riigi vastu ja hävitab selle.
So he called for a prophet by the name of Balaam.
Nõnda ta kutsus profeti.
Balaam decides he's not going to go, but then goes.
Profet, kes algul ei taha minna, ta hiljem otsustab, et läheb.
And he speaks from the Lord.
Ta kõneleb sõna Issandalt.
He prophesies by the power of the Spirit of God.
Profeteerib Jumala vaimuga.
And so what Balak is wanting Balaam to do is to curse Israel.
Ta tahab, et see profet neaks Israeli.
And he sacrificed, the first sacrifice.
Ja ta ohverdab esimese ohvri.
There was no curse.
Ei olnud mingit neebus.
The second one, no curse.
Teine kord samuti.
The third one, no curse.
Kolmas kord samuti.
The fourth, no curse.
Neljas kord samuti.
Balak is very upset.
Ja kuningas on muutumas pahaseks.
I called you to curse Israelites.
Ma kutsusin, et sa neaksid Israelit.
But all you do is bless them.
Ma kõik, mis sa teed, on nende õnnistamine.
Balak said, I cannot curse what God has blessed.
Ja Balak vastab. Ma ei saa teeda, mida Jumal on õnnistanud.
The Israelites, let me just tell you, were not perfect.
Israel, kas ma ütlen, nad ei olnud täiuslikud.
But there was the blood there.
Aga veri oli seal.
There was grace, there was mercy.
Oli arv ja halastus seal.
And the Lord had covered their sin.
Ja Issand oli katnud nende patu.
And Satan could not find an advantage.
Ja Saatan ei leidnud seda võimalust.
So if you search the scriptures, Balaam gives Balak advice.
Nõnda kui vaadata kirjas, siis kuningas annab Balakile nõu.
Here's what you need to do.
Siin on, mida sa pead tegema.
Send in the ladies from the nation into Israel.
Saada naised sellest riigist Israeli rahva hulka.
Get the men to sin.
Pane mehed pottu tegema.
Get them to serve your idols.
Et nad teeniks sinu ebajumalaid.
And the Lord will curse them.
Ja siis Jumal neid näab.
And the result of that were several thousand Israelites were killed.
Ja see tulemus oli, et mitu tuhat Israelast tapeti.
Satan is looking for advantage.
Saatan otsib võimalusi.
A way that he can destroy.
Viisi, kuidas ta saaks hävitada.
And so he gets us to sin or make mistakes.
Nõnda ta paneb meid tegema pattu või vigasid.
Or to even believe that you're not forgiven.
Või isegi panna uskuma, et sul ei ole andestatud.
So that he can continually find a way to create some weak spot in you so that he can get a judgment from God to destroy your life.
Jumala otsuse, mis millega siin tarvitada.
Now I want to read a, I want to tell you a story from Deuteronomy chapter 21, fifth book of Kings.
Viienda Moosese raamatust.
Chapter 21, verses 1 through 9. You can read it later. There is the story of, or a situation in Israel, if an innocent man was killed or murdered, and he was found in the field, that the judges or the rulers from the surrounding cities and the judges, the priests, and the Levites had to come.
Siis ümbruskonna kohtumõistjad, leviidid ja teised pidid tulema kokku.
They would measure from that person to the nearest town. The one that was closest had to bring an ox.
Ja pidid siis mõõtma vahemaa, milline hind oli kõige lähem sellele kohale, kus too lebas ja sealt pidid tooma ohvri.
And the rulers had to say, we are innocent.
Ja juhid pidid ütlema, et meil ei ole süüd.
Of this innocent bloodshed.
Selle süütu vere valamise tõttu.
The ox would be killed.
Ohver tapetakse.
And the Levites would pronounce the blessing of God upon the land.
Ja leviidid öelnuks õnnistuse selle maa peale.
Here's the important thing to understand.
Siin on oluline koht, mida mõista.
That the Bible says whatever you bind on earth is bound in heaven. Whatever you loose on earth is loose in heaven. This is a very good example of binding and loosing. For they were able to bind the curse by the blood. And they were able to bless the land by the word of God. There's a lot of innocent bloodshed.
On väga palju süütud verevalamist.
And innocent bloodshed
süütu verevalamine
causes a curse to come upon the land.
Põhjustab needuse tulemise maa peal.
For example, King Manasseh.
Näiteks kuningas Manasseh.
Killed many children in Israel.
Tappis palju lapsi Iisraelis.
Filled Jerusalem with the blood of innocent people.
Täitis Jerusalemma süütute inimeste verega.
And of babies that were sacrificed unto false gods.
Ja väike lapsed, keda ohverdati eba jumalatele.
And it brought a curse upon Jerusalem and the Lord said, I will destroy Jerusalem.
Ja see tõi Jerusalemma peale needuse ja Issand ütles, ma hävitan Jerusalemma.
But I want to read Ezekiel 22 and 30. Ezekiel 22 and 30. And I sought for a man among them that should make up the heads and stand in the gap before me for the land, that I should not destroy it, but I found none. Chapter 22 and verse 30.
Ezekieli 22 peatükk salm 30. Ma otsin nende hulgast meest, kes laoks müüri.
Ezekiel 22 and 30, and I sought for a man among them that should make up the hedge and stand in the gap before me for the land, that I should not destroy it, but I found none.
Ma otsin nende hulgast meest, kes laoks müüri üles ja seisaks minu ees müüri kraavas maa heaks, et ma seda ei hävitaks, aga ma ei leidu.
Because of the sin that was taking place. Because of the innocent bloodshed.
Selle süütu vere valamise tõttu.
Because of the wickedness of the people.
Inimeste kurjuse tõttu.
The facts brought up to the court.
Need faktid, mis toodi kohtu saali.
The Lord made a decision, I will destroy the land.
Issand tegi otsuse, ma hävitan maa.
But he looked for a lawyer.
Aga ta otsis eestkostja.
Someone that would stand in between him and the land.
Kedagi, kes seisaks tema ja selle maa vahel.
Because he did not want to destroy it.
Kuna ta ei tahtnud seda hävitada.
But he found no one.
Kuna ta ei leidnud kedagi.
Here's an example.
Siin on näide.
The wickedness of Sodom and Gomorrah had gone to the very courts of God.
Sodoma ja Gomorra kurjus oli Jumala kohtu ette jõudnud.
The Lord himself is coming from heaven's court to earth to look into it.
Jumal ise tuleb kohtust alla, et maa peale vaadata, mis oli sündinud.
He is going to destroy Sodom and Gomorrah.
Ta saab hävitama Sodoma ja Gomorra.
But he went to a man who was his friend.
Aga ta läks oma, ta läks mehe juurde, kes oli
who would stand as a lawyer.
Kes seisnud eeskostjana.
That would stand for the city.
Seisnud selle linna eest.
Because God did not want to destroy the people.
Kuna Jumal ei tahtnud rahvast hävitada.
Abraham started off well.
Abrahami algus läks hästi.
If there's 50, would you 50 righteous would you spare it?
Kui leidub 50 õiglast, kas sa siis säästaksid nad?
He goes all the way down to 10.
Ta jõuab terve tee kuni 10.
And he stops.
Ja ta peatub.
If he would just have gone a little bit further.
Kui ta läks ainult pisut kaugemale.
If he would have continued to be a lawyer.
Kui ta oleks jätkanud olemas eestkostja.
Sodom and Gomorrah would have been spared.
Siis Sodom ja Gomorrah oleks nende peale halastatud.
Because the Lord never argued with Abraham.
Kuna Jumal ei vaidle seal.
As long as Abraham asked.
Seni kaua kuni Abraham küsis.
The Lord needed that lawyer to stand there for him. The Lord needed a lawyer to stand there for him.
Jumal vajas eeskostja, kes seisaks seal temaga.
Here's another amazing passage.
Siin on veel väga kirjakoht.
Jesus says in Luke 22.
Jeesus kõneleb Luuka 22. peatükis.
Verses 31 and 32. He says this. I'm just going to kind of talk about it. He said, Peter, Satan has desired to destroy you.
Petrus, Saatan on soov sind hävitada.
But I have prayed for you.
Aga ma olen sinu eest palunud.
Now this word in Greek, desire,
see sõna kreeka keeles soovinud.
In Greek it literally means he requested a trial.
Kreeka keeles see sõna otseses mõttes tähendab, et ta soovis seda kohtu mõistmist.
Satan requested a court date.
Kohtu istungi kuupäeva.
He was going to put Peter on trial.
Ta pannud Peetuse kohtu ette.
See, you think of Peter as preaching on the day of Pentecost.
Me mõtleme Peetusest, kes oli neljapäeval.
But that's not the Peter that Satan knew.
Aga see on Peetus, keda Saatan tundis.
Satan knew of another Peter.
Saatan teadis teistsugust Peetus.
A Peter who made a lot of mistakes.
Peetus, kes tegi palju vigu.
And he requested a trial.
Ja ta soovis kohtu
mõistmist. I want to destroy Peter.
Kohtu mõistmist. Ma soovin hävitada Peetrust.
But the Lord told Peter.
Aga Issand ütles Peetrusele.
I prayed for you.
Ma palusin sinu
eest. I was your lawyer.
Ma olin sinu eestkostja.
If we confess our sin.
Kui me tunnistame oma vatud.
God is faithful and just to forgive us of all of our sin.
Jumal ustab ja õiglane meile need andestab.
And cleanse us of all our iniquity.
Ja peseme meid kõigist meie üleastumistest.
Because of his blood.
Tema vere tõttu.
Because of his sacrifice.
Tema ohvri tõttu.
I want to read 1 Corinthians 6.
Ma lugeda 1. Korintuse 6. peatükist.
Begin in verse 9.
Saimist 9.
Know ye not that the unrighteous shall not inherit the kingdom of God? Be not deceived, neither fornicators, nor idolaters, nor adulterers, nor effeminate, nor abusers of themselves with mankind.
Või te ei tea, et üle kohtusid ei päri Jumala riiki. Ärge eksige, ei kõrvatud, ega juba ebajumala teenijad, ei abielu rükkad, ega lõbupoisid, ega meeste pidastajad.
Nor thieves, nor covetous, nor drunkards, nor revilers, nor extortioners shall inherit the kingdom of God.
Ei vargad, ega ohned, ei joodikud, ega pilkajad, ega riisajad, päri Jumala riiki.
And such were some of you.
Ja sellised olid mõned teie kiseast.
That's us.
Need oleme meie.
Then the next word says this, but.
Aga saimis jätkusel.
Ye are washed. You are sanctified, you are justified in the name of the Lord Jesus and by the Spirit of our God.
Kui teie olete puhtaks pestud. Te olete pühitsetud, te olete õigeks tehtud Issanda Jeesuse Kristuse nimes ja meie Jumala vaimus.
This passage was talking about me.
See kirjakoht kõneleb minu
kohta. About you.
Sinu kohta.
We were condemned to die.
Me olime süüdi mõistatud, et surma.
Not worthy of salvation.
Mitte olemast väärt, et saada päästetud.
On our way to hell.
Tee peal põrgu poole.
But we lifted up our eyes.
aga me tõstsime oma silmad.
And we beheld the sacrifice of Jesus Christ.
Ja me võtsime vastu Jeesuse ohvri.
And we cried out to him, save us.
Me hüüame tema poole, päästa meid.
And we turn from our sin.
Ja me pöördume oma patust.
We confess our sin unto God.
Me tunnistame oma patud Jumalale.
We were baptized in Jesus' name.
Me ristiti Jeesuse nimesse.
And he filled us with the Holy Spirit.
Ja ta täitis meid püha vaimuga.
And when you have received the Holy Spirit,
kui sa oled vastu võtnud püha vaimuga,
you have received the lawyer, Jesus Christ, in your life.
Oled sa vastu võtnud eestkostja Jeesuse Kristuse oma ellu.
Don't let your past define who you are in Christ.
Ära lase oma minevikul defineerida seda, kes sa oled Kristuses.
Learn from your mistakes and stay in him.
Õpi oma vigadest ja püsi temas.
There was a lady found the very act of adultery. A lady found in the act of adultery.
Üks naine tabati abielu rikkumise teolt.
They decided to bring this lady without the man.
Nad otsustasid selle naise ilma meheta tuua.
To the judge.
Kohtuniku ette.
The man that's always speaking the word.
Mees, kes annabki kõneleks sõna.
The one that's telling the Pharisees, you hypocrites, you need to change.
See, kes ütleb fariseeridele, et te olete kirjatundjad, te peate muutma oma tegemist.
They bring him to the creator of the world.
Nad toovad ta maailma looja ette.
They bring him to the one that rose, he raised the dead and cast out devils and healed the sick.
Nad tõid ta selle ette, kes tõstis üles surnuid ja ajas välja kurja vaime.
The one that cast out people out of the temple courtyard.
Selle ette, kes ajas inimesed välja templi õuest.
They brought this adulteress to him.
Nad tõid selle abielu rühka tema ette.
Accusations were made.
Süüdistused.
The judge was there.
Süüdistused tehti kuuldavaks. Kohtunik oli seal olemas.
But that day they didn't just bring this lady to a judge.
Aga sel päeval nad ei tulnud see, et ta naist üksne sai kohtuniku ette.
They brought her to the lawyer.
Nad tõid ta kaitsja, eeskostja ette.
And the lawyer just begins to write down things.
Ja see eeskostja hakkab maha asju kirjutama.
I assume he was writing down facts.
Ma eeldan, et ta pani kirja fakte.
He's writing down something.
Midagi ta paneb sinna igal kirja.
People start getting nervous.
Inimesed hakkavad närviseks muutuma.
You see, they did what Satan would do.
Nad tegid midagi, mida Saatan teinuks.
They created a courtroom situation.
Nad tekitasid kohtusaali olukorra.
And there the Lord defends her.
Ja seal Issand kaitseb teda.
And all the accusers left.
Ja kõik süüdistajad lahkusid.
He said to her, where are your accusers?
Ja ta küsis seda naiselt, kus on sinu süüdistajad?
There was only one that could accuse that day.
Oli ainult üks, kes saanud süüdistada.
There was only one that had not sinned in that place.
Oli ainult üks, kes ei olnud teinud pattu selles paigas.
But he says, I don't condemn you.
Aga ta ütleb, ma ei mõista sinu.
Go and sin no more.
Mine ja ära tee enam pattu.
The great lawyer.
See suur eeskostja.
Jesus Christ.
Jeesus Kristus.
When we talk about even praying for the sick, preaching the gospel,
kui me räägime haigete eest palumisest ja evangeeliumi kuulutamisest,
we find court terms being used.
Me näeme, et kohtusaali termineid kasutatakse seal.
For the Bible says, these signs shall follow them that believe.
Piibel ütleb, need märgid järgnevad neile, kes usuvad.
In my name they shall cast out devils.
Minu nimel nad ajavad välja kurje vaimu.
They're going to speak with new tongues.
Nad kõnelevad teisi keeli.
They're going to take up serpents.
Nad hoiavad madusid.
If they drink any deadly thing, it shall not hurt them.
Kui nad joovad midagi surmavad, siis see ei
mõjuta. They'll lay hands on the sick and they shall recover.
Ei mõjuta neid. Nad panevad käsi haigete peale ja need saavad terveks.
Then the disciples went out and preached everywhere.
Jüngrid läksid välja kõikjale ja kuulutasid.
The Lord worked with them.
Jumal töötas koos nendega.
And confirmed.
Ja kinnitas.
The word with signs following.
Sõna, millega need märgid, millele märgid järgisid.
Here's the amazing thing.
Siin on see hämmastav ka koht.
The Lord does not confirm personalities. The Lord does not grant signs and miracles and wonders because a special preacher preaches.
Jumal ei taga neid tunnustähti selle pärast, et keegi eriline jutlustaja on kõnelemas.
His spirit
tema vaim
bears witness to truth.
On tunnistajaks tõnes.
That's why you can have Somebody off the street preach about Jesus that doesn't even know Jesus.
Seetõttu saab keegi tänaval jutustada Jeesuse kohta, kes isegi ei tea Jeesust.
And a miracle can happen on the streets.
Ja ime saab aset leida.
Because the Lord bears witness of truth.
Kuna Issand on tunnistajaks tõele.
He must bear witness of truth.
Ta peab olema tunnistajaks tõele.
He doesn't bear witness of us.
Ta ei pea tunnistust
meie kohta. But he bears witness, of truth.
Aga ta peab tunnistust tõe kohta.
So if you're ever in a situation,
nõnda kui sa oled kunagi olukorras,
somebody needs to be healed.
Kus keegi vajab tervenemist.
Don't think about your own goodness.
Aga mõtle oma enda heaks osas.
Don't think about all those fancy prayer meetings you have.
Aga mõtle kõikidele nendele vägevatele palvekoosolekutele.
Don't think that that makes you worthy to lay your hands upon somebody to see a miracle.
Kus sa oled olnud, ära mõtle, et see on miski, mis teeb sinu päev panema
käsi. It's the power of the name of Jesus Christ.
Panema käsi kellegi peale.
And in the power of the name of Jesus Christ.
See Jeesuse Kristuse vägi ja tema väel.
Because of what he did.
Selle tõttu, mida tema tegi.
Because the creator came in the flesh.
Kuna looja tuli lihasse.
And because he laid down his life.
Ja kuna ta asetas maha oma elu.
Whenever you speak the name Jesus.
Kuna lihasse kõnele Jeesuse nime.
Something begins to happen in the atmosphere.
Miski hakkab aset leidma.
And the spirit of God begins to move.
Ja Jumala vaim hakkab liikuma.
And God begins to desire to confirm his word.
Ja Jumal hakkab soovima, et kinnitada oma sõna.
And if you will believe it.
Ja kui sa seda usud.
If you will lay hold on the promises of God.
Kui sa hoiad kinni Jumala tõotustest.
Absolutely anything can happen.
Absoluutselt mis iganes saab aset leida.
We were in Kiev in January.
Jaanuaris me olime Kiievis.
At the end of January.
Jaanuari lõpus.
And a young girl came forward at the end.
Ja
or at the beginning of one of the services, there were several that day.
Ühel päeval oli mitu teenistust ja ühe nende algusest tuli üks väike tüdruk esile.
Her mom and her dad brought her forward.
Tema vanemad tõid tema ette.
Everybody was sitting there. We were getting ready to start service.
Kõik olid istumas, me olime valmistumas, et alustada teenistusega.
The mom says,
ema ütles,
my daughter, her daughter was about this tall.
Mu tütar, kes oli umbes nii kõrge, nii pikk.
She only can see 40%.
Tal oli nägemisvõime ainult 40%.
And she has believed all day that God will heal her eyes.
Ja ta on kogu päeva uskunud, et Jumala teeb terveks tema silmad.
And so we laid hands upon her.
Ma asetasin oma käed tema peale.
And as we're praying,
ja sellel, kui me palatsime,
we're speaking in the name of Jesus.
Kõnelesime Jeesuse nime.
We're binding the weakness of the eye and loosing blessing upon her sight.
Sidusime kinni tema silmade nõrkuse ja vabastasime tervenemise.
As she began to believe it,
kui ta hakkas seda uskuma,
as she began to thank God for it,
ja hakkas tänama Jumalat selle eest,
something began to happen to her eyesight.
Hakkas midagi aset leidma tema nägemises.
I felt the Spirit of God say to me, have her practice.
Ma tundsin, et Jumala vaim mulle ütles, et
sa so I told her to stop and look around.
Ja ma peatsin ta ja ütlesin, et ta vaatas
she ringi. She began to look around.
Ta hakkas ringi vaatama.
She was shocked.
Ta oli hämmastunud.
It's better.
See asjad on parem.
Her confidence was growing.
Tema meelekindlus
kasvas. I said, let's do it again.
Võtsime proovime veel korda.
Now people are standing up and they're looking.
Nüüd on inimesed seilmas ja vaatamas.
We didn't scream.
Me ei karinud.
We didn't jump up and down.
Me ei hüpanud üles alla.
We didn't smack ourselves.
Me ei tagunud iseennast.
We didn't hurt ourselves.
Me ei teinud endale haiget.
Because God already came in the flesh and he was beaten.
Sest Jumal kord juba tuli lihasse ja teda peksti.
He was whipped for us.
Teda piitsutati meie eest.
Not you.
Mitte sind.
Not me.
Mitte mind.
Your responsibility is to speak.
Sinu kohustus on, et kõneleda.
Your responsibility is to bless.
Sinu kohustus on, et õnnistada.
And so we prayed again.
Nõnda me palutasin uuesti.
And as the Spirit of God began to move upon her,
ja kui Jumala vaim hakkas tema peal
liikuma, I told her, just thank God that you are healed.
Ma ütlesin talle, lihtsalt täna Jumala, et
she began to thank God that she was healed.
Et ta on siit tervendanud, hakkas seda tegema.
And the power of God fell upon her.
Ja Jumala vaim hakkas tema peale.
And instantaneously confirmed
ja hetkega kinnitas
his word
oma sõna.
With signs followed.
Märkidega, mis järgmis.
And healed her just like that.
Ja tervedas ta nõnda.
Hallelujah! 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 Now,
et see kirjakohtub ole.
These signs follow great believers.
Need märgid järgnevad nendele, kes on suured uskujad.
No, that's not what Bible says.
Ei, see ei ole, mida Biblia ütleb.
Believers!
Uskujad.
He confirms his word with signs following.
Ta kinnitab oma sõna märkidega, mis järgnevad.
For believers!
Uskujate jaoks.
Those that have the boldness to proclaim truth.
Neile, kes on julgust kuulutada tõde.
God confirms truth.
Jumal kinnitab tõde.
Brother Daniel the Temple had me send in a video, a preaching video, to the Republic of Georgia.
Mulle saadeti üks jutluse video Gruusias.
I sent in a very short one, 10 minutes, maybe 8.
Võib-olla 8.
Well, God used those 8 minutes.
Jumal kasutas seda 8 minutit.
And he called me afterwards.
Ja ta kõnes minuga hetke.
There's a man that wants to talk to you.
On üks mees, kes tahab sinuga kõneleda.
He's been seeking the Holy Ghost for a couple of years.
Ta on mõned aastad juba otsinud püha vaimu.
He wants to call you.
Ta tahab sulle helistada.
He wants you to pray with him. He wants the Holy Spirit.
Ta tahab, et sa temaga koos palvetaksid. Ta tahab vastu võtta püha vaimu.
Allah, God works through phones.
Jumal tegutseb ka läbi telefoni.
Because he confirms his word with signs following.
Kuna ta kinnitab oma sõna märkidega, mis järgnevad.
So I gave him truth.
Nõnda ma andsin talle tõe.
And there on that telephone.
Ja seal on selle telefoni kõnelise.
God baptized him with the Holy Spirit.
Jumal ristis ta pühavaimuga.
And he began to speak with other tongues.
Ja ta hakkas kõnelema teisi keeli.
These signs follow believers.
Need märgid järgnevad uskujatele.
It doesn't say these signs follow great believers.
Ei ole kirjas, et need märgid järgnevad suurtele uskujatele.
Or pastors.
Või pastoritele.
Although they should.
Kuigi need peaksid samuti.
Says believers.
Aga seal on kirjas uskujatele.
So get your eyes off yourself.
Nõnda võta oma silmad enese pealt ära.
And get your eyes on truth.
Ja sea oma silmad oma tõe peale.
And if you will speak in Jesus' name.
Ja kui sa kõneled Jeesuse nimel.
God can begin to do the miracle.
Saab Jumal selle ime läbi viia.
I'm 49 years old. I have a confession to make. I'm 49 years old.
Ma olen 49, ma olen midagi tunnistada.
I still don't wear glasses.
Ma endiselt ei kanna prille.
Although I've almost gotten them.
Kuigi ma olen üsna ligidal.
My eyes have gotten so bad so many times.
Üsna ligidal, et neid hankida, kuna mu silmad on halvemaks läinud.
But I prayed for many people with bad eyesight. God healed them.
Aga ma olen paljude halva silma nägemas. Silma nägemisega inimeste eest palvetanud.
I don't want to be one of those guys that are wearing these small little things on their nose as they preach.
Ja mõtlesin, ma ei taha kandast neid teised asju nende sarnased, kes teised, kes sa jutustavad.
I want my nose to be visible for everybody.
Ma tahan, et mu nina oleks kõigile nähtav.
So there was this one particular time.
Nõnda oli üks kord.
There was a pastor that wanted to be healed.
Üks pastor, kes tahtis saada terveldatud.
He came at the end of the service in front of everybody.
Ta tuli teenistuse lõpus kõigile nähtavalt.
This is one of my first times to pray for a man that had bad eyesight.
Ja see oli mu esimene kord, kui ma palvetasin kellegi eest, kellel oli halb silmanägemine.
It happened to be the first person to come forward for healing.
Ja see oli juhtus ajal esimene inimene, kes tuli
I was very scared.
Ette saada terveldatud.
I was thinking about me and not about Jesus.
Ma olin väga hirmu, ma mõtlesin enda peale, mitte Jeesuse peale.
I said, God will heal you now in Jesus' name.
Mõtlesin, et Jumal saab sind tervendama nüüd Jeesuse nimel.
I barely believed it.
Ma vaevu uskusin seda.
But I said it with confidence.
Aga ma ütlesin seda kindlusega.
And so I laid my hands upon him.
Ma asetsin oma käed tema peale.
Everybody's watching.
Kõik olid vaatamas.
And I had him open his eyes and said, can you see any better?
Ja ma ütlesin, ta avaks oma silmad ja küsisin, kas ta näeb paremini nüüd.
He said no.
Ütlesin, ei.
I was like, dear God, that's exactly what I thought he would say.
Ja ma ütlesin, oh Jumal, see on täpselt see, mida ma kartsin, et ta saab ütlema.
I said, we will do it again.
Ja ma ütlesin, et teeme seda uuesti.
With greater faith, as I said. With greater boldness and faith.
Suurema julguse ja usuga.
We prayed again.
Oletasin uuesti.
And then I began to try and listen to what God would somehow tell me.
Ja siis ma hakkasin kuulama, mida Jumal ütles mulle öelda.
And I felt an impression in my spirit to give him a Bible that was on the pulpit.
Ja ma tundsin, et ma peaksin andma talle ühe piibli, mis
oli a stack of Bibles.
Mis oli seal puldi peal.
I didn't ask him, are you healed? I reached over and grabbed a Bible. I said, read it.
Seal oli hulk piibli. Ma otsin ühe nendest ja andsin temale ja ütlesin, et oleks.
I gave him the Bible. I opened it.
Ma tegin selle lahti.
And it was the smallest print I've ever seen.
Ja see oli kõige peenem
I was going to close it and give him another one.
Ma tahtsin selle sulgeda ja anda talle teistsuguse piibli.
But I was already given it to him.
Ja ma olin seda talle juba üle andnud.
So I said, read it.
Ma siin talle loe ette.
And he stood there looking at it.
Ta seisis vaatas selle peale.
I am pleading with Jesus as a lawyer. I am talking to the Lord as a lawyer.
Ma olen Jumalaga kõnelemas.
Pleading with him, dear God.
Palun Jumala.
Heal him immediately.
Tervendal ta hetkega siin.
And he's looking at the Bible.
Ta vaatab selle piibli poole.
And then all of a sudden he began to read it.
Ja hetkega ta hakkas seal lugema.
As God instantaneously healed him.
Kui Jumal tegi ta hetkega terveks.
I was the one that was shouting the most in that place in Jesus' name.
Mina olin see, kes kõige enam hüüdis seal kohas Jeesus nimel.
But I realized this.
Aga ma mõistsin seda.
God confirms truth.
Jumal kinnitab tõde.
Not you.
Mitte sina.
Not me.
Mitte mina.
And if you will speak truth.
Ja kui sa kõneled tõde.
And if you begin to thank him for it.
Ja kui sa hakkad teda selles
peale. If you begin to practice your miracle.
Ja kui sa hakkad oma imet
time and time again God's healed my eyes.
Pidevalt ja uuesti on minu silmid Jumal tervendanud.
He's healed my body.
Pidevalt ja uuesti on ta minu ihu
tervendanud. Time and time again he's healed you.
Pidevalt ja uuesti on ta sind tervendanud.
We have a great opportunity to help many people.
Meil on suur võimalus, et aidata
paljusid. There's a lot of hurting people in our world.
On väga palju haiget saanud inimesi meie maailmas.
And these signs follow you.
Ja need märgid järgnevad sinule.
There is a court going on.
On kohtusaal, mis on
every day it's happening.
Iga päev leiab seal see.
God's looking for somebody that will stand in the gap for Tallinn.
Kes seisaks selles müüri praos Tallinna
ees. That will stand as a lawyer for Estonia.
Kes seisaks eestkostjana Eesti ees.
That will stand as a lawyer for your friends and your family.
Kes seisaks eestkostjana sinu sõprade ja pere ees.
They don't have a lawyer.
Neil ei ole eestkostjat.
You have the lawyer.
Sinul on eestkostja.
And God wants you to stand in the gap.
Ja Jumal tahab, et sa seisaksid selles müüripraos.
And pray for their salvation.
Ja palataksid nende pääste
eest. And miracles, signs and wonders will begin to take place.
Ja imed ja märgid ja tunnustajad saavad aset leidma.
Understand who we are in Jesus Christ.
Mõistkem, kes me oleme Jeesuses Kristuses.
We are ambassadors.
Me oleme saadikud.
We do not whine, we do not beg, we do not plead.
Me ei vingu ega anu.
We speak with authority.
Me kõneleme meelevallaga.
Because we know truth.
Kuna me tunneme tõde.
And God confirms truth.
Ja Jumal kinnitab tõde.
Let's talk to God for a few moments, can we?
Kõneleme Jumalaga hetkel.
Father, in the name of Jesus Christ.
Ja Jeesus Kristus.
We thank you, Father, for your word.
Me täname sind sinu sõna eest.
We thank you, Lord, that you hear us when we pray.
Me täname sind kuuled meid, kui me palatame.
Lord, we are sorry for our sins.
Me kahetseme oma patte.
We ask you, God, to forgive us for our sins. That you would have mercy upon us, O God. And that you would forgive us. And God, we pray for our city. We pray for Tallinn. We pray for Estonia. God, I pray that you would forgive innocent bloodshed. That you would have mercy upon this land. And that you would forgive the wickedness. And extend mercy to Estonia.
Annaksid armu Jumal.
And that you would pronounce your blessing upon this land.
Et sa kuulutaksid oma õnnistust selle maa peal.
And cause this place to be innocent.
Ja seaksid selle paiga süütuks.
That your favor would rest upon Estonia.
Et su hea meel oleks Eesti üle.
That your favor would rest upon our families and our friends.
Et su hea meel oleks meie perele ja sõprade üle.
And that you would have mercy upon us.
Et sa halastaksid meie
peale. Have mercy upon our friends and family and upon our nation.
Halasta meie sõprade, meie pere ja meie riigi peale.
We ask for your salvation to come.
Me palume sinu pääste tuleks.
We ask for your healing to come.
Palume sinu tervenemine tuleks.
And that you would have mercy upon us, O God.
Ja et sa halastaksid meie peale.
Hear us, O Lord, tonight.
Kuule meid täna õhtul.
And loose your healing upon us.
Ja vabasta oma tervenemine meie
peale. Loose your healing upon our families.
Vabasta meie meie perede peale.
Loose your healing upon this land.
Selle maa peale.
In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ.
Jeesuse nimel.
In Jesus' name. I want to give you one final principle and conclusion.
Ma tahan ühe põhimõtte veel anda lõpetuseks.
What good is a message without a conclusion?
Mis hea on sõnum ilma lõpetamiseta?
Job, his family, his children.
Job, tema pere, tema lapsed.
If you look at Job chapter 1, they had a lot of parties.
Kui vaadata Job esimest peatükki, siis nad pidasid väga palju pidusid.
Job was afraid that his children had sinned.
Job kartisid, et ta lapsed olid pattu teinud.
So every morning,
nõnda iga hommik,
he would get up and make a sacrifice.
Ta tõusus ja anduks ohvri Jumalale.
Because perhaps his children had sinned.
Kuna võib olla tema patu, tema lapsed olid patu.
He operated as a lawyer.
Ja ta toimis kui eeskostja.
So when Satan comes before the throne,
nõnda kui Satan tuleb trooni ette,
Satan says something very interesting.
Satan ütleb midagi väga huvitavat.
I cannot touch his family.
Ma ei saa tema peret puudutada.
I cannot touch his home.
Ma ei saa tema koda puudutada.
I cannot touch him.
Ma ei saa teda puudutada.
He's untouchable.
Ta on puudutamatu.
Why?
Mille pärast?
Job learned to pray for his family.
Õppis selgeks, et palvetada oma perele eest.
Job learned to be a lawyer.
Ta õppis olema eeskostja.
For his home.
Oma koja eest.
We need to do that for our homes.
Me peame seda oma kodude.
We need to do that for our city and for our nation.
Kodude jaoks, oma linna riigi jaoks tegema.
We need to do that for our friends and for our family.
Oma sõprade eest, pere eest tegema.
Satan already has a plan to destroy.
Satan on juba plaan olemas.
He's working very hard.
Kuidas hävitada, ta näeb väga palju vaeva seda.
But let it be said like Jesus said.
Aga olgu öeldud nagu Jeesus ütles.
I have prayed for you.
Ma olen sinu eest palunud.
God bless you, Jesus.
Jumala eest palunud. Jeesus Kristus. Jeesus
Kristus.
Jeesus Kristus. Jeesus Kristus. Jeesus Kristus. Jeesus
Oh God, we thank you for your great love. We thank you for your mercy. This stretches to the heavens. Oh God, we thank you that you found us.
You
lifted us out from where you found us.
You
established us on the walk.
Ja kinnitanud meid.
Hallelujah. Thank you for this good word
tonight.
Aga
praegu ära jää ilma sellest võimalusest.
Why don't we just reach out to Jesus Christ? In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus Christ. Oh Jesus, we thank you. Thank you for your grace. Hallelujah. If you're here with someone or you're watching with someone, you're from the same family under the same roof, why don't you take them by the hand? Put your hand on their shoulder. Let's pray for one another today. Why don't you do that in Jesus' name? Lord, we pray that you would touch our families. We pray that you would touch our roommates. We pray, Lord Jesus, that you would minister to our relatives. Hallelujah. Touch us, O God. Let your spirit rest upon our lives.
Before 3 o'clock tomorrow.